Well, they're not exactly naked, but, you know, it depends on what you mean by the degree of nakedness. Yes, I see, you know, you have naked shoulders and whatnot and naked face. You know, some societies do not allow you to have a naked face. If you're a female, you have to cover up your face. Okay? It depends on how much nakedness there is. Now, I don't see people walking around completely naked, but that might be in the making. There are groups of people, mostly white, I mean, who are advocating all kinds of things in the area of sex. Because, see, nakedness has to do with a connection with sex. Otherwise, people would just not, you know, they didn't feel like wearing clothes, they wouldn't wear clothes. Why do people wear clothes? Just to protect from the elements? No. You cover up certain parts of the body. All right? Now, the white supremacists in the area, the eighth area of activity, anything that has to do directly or indirectly with sex, they pay strict attention to it when it comes to non-white people. All right? They want that non-white male to be more effeminate here in 2018. All right? They got the non-white male because they put him in that position. Non-white males, when they come on television, who do they talk about? They don't mention anything about a father. They always say their mother, their grandmother.
Yes.
Well, my mother did this. My mother told me this. My grandmother told me. Why? Or my sister told me they came up in a house full of females. All right. The only males there were their brothers. Okay. So the females were in the house because the male has been beaten down so much, the black male, in many of what you call households, that he's non-existent. He's out. You know, there are no so-called fathers. Of course, there can't be fathers and mothers in the system of white supremacy that are black anyway. So the boy learns from the female. So he becomes more and more effeminate.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that just goes with the package. He copies after his sisters. He wants to be like his sisters. And his sisters' friends, who are all girls,
mm-hmm.
they come around and they sit around and they make girl talk. And the boy, 3, 4, 5 years old, he learns to make girl talk. Now, at some point, he wants to be what? A man. Now he's got to make a choice if he's going to become more effeminate. Or is he going to become what the fellas that dropped out of school became? Thugs. So this is the choice that the white supremacists give the black male. You can either be a little girl all your life when you're 40 years old, you're walking around looking for some other male to feel all over your body, you know, and entertain you in that way. Or you're going to be a stone hoodlum terrorizing everybody that you can encounter on a street corner, in the house that you are in, among your so-called friends, or in the neighborhood where you are, because you know better than to go among the white supremacists with your gang and start anything, because your gang will be non-existent in about 5 minutes and you know that. So see, you do all this, one of the three T's, terrorism, right where you are, all right, and that's your plan for the rest of your existence.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if you don't want to be that, and the white supremacists say, yeah, you can be that, then I got another option for you. You don't want to be a black thug, all right, and glorify thugism, glorify terrorizing grandmothers on bus stops and whatnot. If you don't want to be that, then you can be a 30, 40-year-old, 20-year-old, 18-year-old aspiring female, but you're a black male.
Yes.
And you females, because you don't have a male, you all can all get in bed with each other and find something to do. Take off your clothes and just roll around in the bed with each other, all of you, with your sisters. You can start off with your sisters and then spread it all over the neighborhood. All you girls sitting around making girl talk, and when the talk gets boring, whatnot, then get naked and lay around in bed with each other. And that is an ideal situation for you scraps of garbage people. Because that's all you are garbage anyway. in the eyes of the white supremacists. And I'll help you. I'll finance you when you have this type of behavior. If you're going to be a black male entertainer, hey, you better come in this office switching, all right, with your behind turned up or exposed, all right, and let me know where you're coming from, because you don't come to a white person with that thug mentality, because we know we will devastate you if you do that. You don't come to us with that. I don't care what kind of hip-hop songs you sing among yourself. Don't get in my face with that garbage.
Wow.
Because I'll put you in your place.
Yes, sir.
Now, but if you tame it, all right, and put that earring in your ear, now we're talking. Drop your pants a little bit. Now we're getting somewhere, boy.